guys, welcome back to another, well, pretty much the very first ever how-to League of Legends video. I've been playing League of Legends on and off for about 2.5 years, 3 years, and pretty much I've recently gotten back into playing League of Legends. And in my search for playing League of, for looking for guides, builds, things like that, I've come across the fact that there is quite literally no YouTube videos that are tailor-made for new players. And when I mean new, I don't mean like returning players, I mean brand new level one account players. There just isn't. And so today, I hope that this video is going to come across as something similar to that. Now, once you've made your account with Riot and you've confirmed your email address and done all that fun stuff, and you've downloaded the game, you've patched it, there's an update or whatnot, and you've clicked login, this is what you're going to see. This is the client, basically. You're going to see the play button where you can start playing. This is your summoner icon that you can change. Now, you'll get more icons as you play and level up. Also, you'll get unique icons like these one with the two hands for doing good deeds in the game. You get rewards for doing good, not being a toxic player. Now, I'll explain what some of the short terminologies are in the video. My dog just probably wants me to tell you now, but anyway, long story short, before you even click play or anything else, what I need you to do is I need you to pull up a Google, okay, and just type in League of Legend champion builds. Okay, and you're going to get to a whole bunch of different websites. For example, you will get to LOL Kings, you'll get to Moba Fire, you'll get to Pro Builds. And what these are a rough champion build ideas that are done by actual pro players of League of Legends. Now, I'm not asking you to quite literally cut and paste, cut and paste, cut and paste. That's not what I'm saying. What I am saying is use them to help guide you. Okay, that's the idea of a guide. It is to guide you. So like I said, and now the best thing about League of Legends is you'll click on this little icon, view, edit your summoner profile, click champions, and it lists all the champions that you have. Now, as you can see, I do have quite a few scattered champions. That's because I play specific classes and roles. Now, if you see an exclamation point above them, that means that that champion is free for that week for you to use. Okay, there is always 7 champions that are rotated in every week for you to use. For example, I could click available. These are all of my available champions. Again, the exclamation points that you see denote that they are free champions. You don't own them, but you can use slash play with them. Champions that you do purchase, you purchase with either two forms of currency: Riot points, which is their premium currency, or IP or influence points. That is the currency you will get through playing the game. Now, to purchase a champion, first things first, make sure you've got either enough Riot points or enough influence points. Now, if you wish to purchase Riot points, you click on the little plus RP, you'll get a pop-up. You can select multiple different forms, including gift cards. If you've got like a Burger King gift card, you can even do mobile payments, you can do prepaid cards. Now, the prepaid Riot cards you can purchase at Walmart, Target, Walgreens, 7-Eleven. You can get them literally anywhere that prepaid credit cards or gift cards are sold. I actually can get my Riot point cards from my local Family Dollar because they actually have them at my local Family Dollar. Now, as you can see, each purchase, it tells you $100 will get you basically 15,000 Riot points, denoting on the amount. Now, me, I'm probably just going to do a straightforward, simple $10 purchase. So I'm going to click that. First things first, I have to go back to my payment because I buggered up. Anyway, you click blooper here for you. Click the RP, you get a pop-up. Click pay. I plan on paying with PayPal. So that, it asks for your PayPal information. And this is where you will give your PayPal information. My transaction is complete. And as you can see, I now have my riot points. Now, you can purchase champions with riot points, you can purchase skins with riot points. You cannot purchase a skin without owning the champion first. So that's just a straightforward FYI for you. Now, as you can see, champions can, you can either fill, you can click on, see, 50% off, i.e. they're on sale. There's Elise, Lissandra, Kilif, Falgar, Sanzu, Greaves. Like I said, there's a lot of champions that are on sale right now. I don't intend on getting any of these champions, they don't suit my playstyle. But you can sort them out by assassin, by fighter, by mage, by marksman. I like ranged characters, so marksmans are the ones I'm interested in. Caitlyn, for example, Ashe, as you can see, I own Miss Fortune. Cogmore is one I've always wanted to look at, started to play at. But lately I've found actually one that I really do like, and that is Scorn. Scorn is a tank build. Right there, there's Scorn. I've actually fallen in love with Scorn simply because he just loosely reminds me of Astaroth from Soul Calibur. But like I said, that's pretty much how you would purchase a champion. You click on that, now you could choose riot points or you could choose influence points. As you can see, I do not have enough influence points, so it automatically denotes what currency I do have enough of, i.e. riot points. Now, I'm not going to be buying Olaf, but I'm just using that as an example for you guys. So also, you can also get other things. For example, you click on gameplay, you can buy the runes and quintessences. Now, this is one of the parts of the video that it's going to be its own video. So what I want you to do now is to click, there'll be an annotation that pops up somewhere in this video. I would like you to click on that. Okay, I'm just going to show you the area here so you can get familiarized with the game. And there's also accessories. This is where you can get rune pages. Now, I don't suggest you bother with the hex keys and the locked boxes and everything else, because those are for champion players who are like level rank 30 plus. This is end game content, so just ignore that part right now. You can click on bundles and you can get the starter bundle. Now, I already have the starter bundle. As you can see, I have every champion, but you do get an XP booster and an IP booster, things like that. As you can see, I own every single one of the champions from the starter bundle because I bought a starter bundle at my local Walmart. Then you can get the digital collector's edition, there are various other additions you can get. But I like to click on accessory. No, it's not accessories, is it accessories? I think it's accessories and summoner icons. And this is where you can buy custom icons that are just like this one reminds me of Ultimate Warrior and stuff like that and whatnot. But like I said, guys, you don't necessarily need any of these. So featured is usually what they're trying to sell you right away. There are things where you can get like rune pages. I believe those are under gameplay. Well, anyway, apparently the rune page section has disappeared. Anyway, rune pages, again, will be in its own separate video. There'll be an annotation that just popped up. Click that and it'll take you to a different video where I explain the rune pages, same as the masteries and same as the spells, as well as how to set up your first item sets. So again, guys, check those videos out. Click on those when they pop up and take the video on from there. But from this video onwards, we're going to be talking about things like your first win of the day bonus. What that is an IP, a flat IP and a flat EXP bonus of 1.25%. So pretty much, where if you only get, say, 50 EXP in that game, you'll get about 75 to 80. So, you know, it's not much, but it does start to add up. As you can see, I am already level 21 on this account. This is my main account, by the way, guys. I don't have any alt accounts. And so, as you can see, I'm not level 30, so I don't have, so you must be level 30 to play ranked games. I don't play ranked. Or anything like that, because I'm not level 30. This is why I'm doing this video, because I'm trying to explain to you guys about how to be level 30. Yeah, you know what you need to do in order to become level 30. Yes, I have played against other players as Miss Fortune and as Twisted Fate, one of my two favorite champions. Now, first things first, as you're leveling up, you will start to unlock specific spells. For example, Clarity unlocks at level 1, Ghost at level 1, Heal at level 1, Mark at level 1, Barrier at level 4, Exhaust, Cleanse and Teleport is level 6, Flash is level 8, Ignite is level 10, and Smite is level 10. So as you're leveling up from 0 to 10, you will start to unlock these spells. Now, these spells is what you as a player can do against enemy, other champions and various other things. These do not... Basically, for example, if you picked Alistair, which is a champion, he can use any of these skills because it goes off of you, the player, not the champion. Now, masteries. Every time you rank up from 0 to 30, you will get one mastery point. Mastery points can be spent, and you can actually build as many masteries as you want. For example, let's create this one, and we'll just call this one Toot. Okay? Like, toot, toot. Now, there is three forms: Ferocity, Cunning, and Resolve. Resolve is usually meant for your tanky characters. If you like melees, for example, Garen, Spin to Win, a lot of people tend to use a lot of, a lot of Resolve with a dash of Ferocity thrown in. Ferocity is your damage. Cunning is your abilities, i.e., for example, if you're a mage class, a lot of mages use cunning. If you're an AD carry, a lot of people use ferocity with a dash of cunning or a dash of resolve thrown in, depending on what champion you play. Now, when you first start the game, you're only going to have either 0 or 1 point. And most players will tell you don't spend anything until you're at least rank 5. And I do agree with that. Don't bother spending a single mastery point. And it's free, of course. You can reset the mastery points as many times as you want. As you can see, I've got 21 points available because I am level 21. So, this is what we're going to do. I am going to basically just spend my first 5 points. Now, if you look on the Ferocity page, you've got Fury, which is attack speed. That's great if you're a slow melee champion, i.e. Scorn, who's very, very slow, but swings his weapon very, very hard. Ash, she's a ranged character. She does quite well with attack speed increase because of her passive abilities and slows and snares. So if you want to be a support champion, i.e. sitting in the back, pegging away with your arrows, slowing other enemy champions down so your friendly champions, like your assassins or your marksmen, could snipe them. One time I record a video, there's a traffic jam outside my house. Typical. Well, anyway, you might want to look at getting Fury. Now, Sorcery, that increases your ability damage, your AD damage. Now, if you're an AD carry, that's the sort of skill you want to go for. So, people like Misfortune, who rely on their abilities. Now, abilities go off your Q, W, E, and R keys on your keyboard. Moving a champion is not a WASD key. It's not a WASD. It's you move your mouse. Okay, you'll learn all of that in the tutorial, so I'm not really going to be covering that section of the tutorial. But what I will cover is things that you can need. Now, Wanderer, movement speed out of combat. So when you're not in combat, you're a lot faster. So junglers will actually take Wanderer a lot. Savagery, again, junglers. A jungler is a type of champion that doesn't necessarily, for example, assassins, they're usually jungler characters, simply because they want to attack the monsters, get the blue buff, red buff, whatever, dragon, things like that, baron, and then have those buffs augment the weaknesses of their champions, wait for an enemy champion to be, on low health, and then pop out of nowhere, gank them, get the kill, and then rinse and repeat. That's what a jungler does. A jungler like Rengar, who just got reworked, by the way, beautiful on the rework, would use things like Savagery. Now, tank characters like Garen, Scorn, Malphite, Alistair, they would use things like Recovery or Unyielding, which is a flat armor bonus and magic resist, which is perfect for Alistair, because one of Alistair's weaknesses, if you don't set him up right, AD characters or just destroy you. Because especially with Malphite. With Malphite, he needs Malphite's armor he's a unique champion because the more health he has, the more armor he has. Okay, so you want to go flat hit, just health build with Malphite. And then throw in a little bit of something like the Black Cleaver or Dosmoru's Blade to get an attack speed increase. So you could try that. I've seen that work in some games. Not all, but I've seen it work in some. Also, Orion Soul, one of the newer champions. He's a dragon. I still haven't got to grips with Orion yet. He's a head scratcher, that's for sure. But like I said, these I have multiple pages for different builds. For example, this is just a flat out Verocity build. This is what I do for my AD carry. For example, Misfortune, things like that. Again, this is another Misfortune build I'm currently in the works on doing. It's not finished yet, as you can see. This is my Twisted Fate version 2 that I've been working on. Again, it's not done yet. It's almost there. I mean, the masteries that you see here won't be done until you're level 30 and you've got all your mastery points to spend. So like I said, I like to dilly dally. This is my tank build. This is what I use for generic tank classes. For example, Malphite, Alistair, Scorn, is I tend to go straight, flat out, you know, tanky class. So any tanker, I tend to just automatically use this page. And then Scorn, this one is specifically designed for the champion Scorn. Now again, it's not finished, so it's something I'm tweaking as I'm going along. And again, mastery pages, you can have as many mastery pages as you want, but rune pages you have to buy, and for some reason I can't find them in the shop. So don't ask me why, I just can't. So we're going to take a look at this tutorial page, and say we're going to make it for a mage. Okay, so we're going to do this for a mage class. So we want to do, bam, we want to increase our damage. What else? Expose weakness, damaging enemy champions causes them to take 3% more damage from allies. So that's really great if you want to play someone who's a support mage like Ryze or Aryan Soul or I really am thinking here, Brad, even for example, Brad who likes to use AoEs. Annie, she likes to use AoE. Hey Tibbers, you know, one of my wife's favorite champions. That would be a good thing to take, but I know a lot of mages like to take Fresh Blood, which is you do additional damage per attack against champions. So your first basic attack against champions deals an additional 10 plus 1 damage per level with a 6-second cooldown. I also know that a lot of people like to take Feast, especially if you want to stay in lane, i.e. killing a unit restores 20 health with a 30-second cooldown. That's not too bad for long lane sustain. For example, if you play Garen, again, I keep going back to Garen, but Garen is a champion that has a passive heal. When he's out of combat, he heals faster. So that would be a really good thing if you wanted to stay in lane with Garen, who's actually a pretty cheap champion to buy. He's actually one of the starter champions that I showed you in the starter set you could buy for like $5. That's not a bad move from there. Now you probably want to go, you could go on Yielding for the 5% bonus armor and magic resist. Again, if you're planning on going like a very, I wouldn't say glass cannon a champion, but if you're going like a tank champion, that wouldn't be a bad idea. Go with tough skin. You've taken take two less damage from champions and neutral monsters' basic attacks. So for example, if you're lane pushing, tough skin is actually a good thing to take, especially for champions like Misfortune, who is quite squishy, and she relies on not getting hit. So you could go there. Natural talent or vampirism again is good for lane sustain, which is a flat 2% lifesteal, and spell vamp. So if you cast spells, you're getting mana back. If you do health damage, you gain life back. Again, you know, this is something, again, this is a build that you could work on. For example, you can then go over to Runic Armor, which is shields, healing, regeneration, and lifesteal are 6.4% stronger. So vampirism and Runic Armor actually go in tandem. So again, this would be a good little lane sustain build. So, you know, we could just add that, click save mastery. So there we go, we've spent all of our points, which is 21 points, 11 in ferocity, 10 in resolve, none in cunning. So we really don't want to go with a mage character, because again, you know, or an assassin, because there's nothing there to help them. But if we go tank, or if we go fighter, you know, or support, we've got something there, you know. And then of course runic pages, of course I can't find the section where you can buy the extra pages. That's why I bought the rage points, was to buy some more runic pages, but for some reason I just can't seem to find them. So point edit break here. I'm gonna find those goddamn runic pages. Driving me nuts. Ah, there it is. Ha ha! Well, there you go, guys. Found it. It was show all, show all, show all, boom. Additional rune page, which I just bought. Ugh, finally. I've only been asking for that forever. So we go to our rune page now. Boom, there's our third rune page. Now, again, as you level up, guys, you will get mastery points and rune pages, rune slots. As you can see, because I'm level 21, I have quite a few slots unlocked. So, first things first, before we buy any runes, let's look at the champions and we'll find what champion we want to do for this tutorial. Okay, I'm gonna collect on owned. Okay, these are the champions I own. Now let's see, we could do a Narcissus, no. Scorn, no. Rise, no. I want to do like a hybrid, maybe Pantheon, maybe. Oh no, because again, he's a marksman, he's an assassin. So let's pick Shivar. There you go, Manon. Oh, she's a marksman too. So there we go. I'm actually, I'm digging that skin. That's pretty nice. Okay, so let's take a look at her abilities. Tips. Shivar's boomerang blade returns to her, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so most of her stuff is probably, let's find someone. We've got to find the champion first, so then we can build the rune page around her. Of course, there's Morgana. She's a support mage. Quite annoying because she has lots of stuns and slows. Ashe, of course, again, support player. And we could go with a support build. Master Yi, he's an assassin. I'm not a big fan. Believe it or not, I'm not a fan of Master Yi. I'm just not. Or Amumu. He can be quite powerful. There's Soraka. I'm thinking, guys. I'm thinking. What do you think? What do you guys think? Garen? Yeah, let's build it around Garen, shall we? Fighter who goes staunch AP. So we're going flat attack power, right? So now we know this is for Garen. Okay, so we're going to go masteries. Two. I'm going to put Gare. So we know it's for Garen. Okay? So we're going to go to our rune page now. And we're going to go to page 3. I'm actually going to name this one Toot Gare. So again, we know it's for Garen. Okay, click save. Now, let's take a look and we'll go physical attack. So it's attack damage. Lethality. Physical damage. Attack speed. Let's go with attack damage. Straight 80. So right there's an instant 3.5 attack damage. Okay, now let's look at our marks. Physical attack, greater physical attack damage. Now again, some of these runes you won't have, guys, because some of these runes aren't even in the game anymore. They got phased out because there's physical damage left. We could just go flat lethality if we want. That way our ultimate will just fucking one shot people. We could go with attack speed, not that I'd want to do that, so we go with more physical attack damage. Bam, so we're up to 10 physical damage now. And seals, again, more physical damage, but with the seals, we're actually gonna go defense. We could go flat armor, like so. And glyphs, go with flat magic resist. So then that way mages don't just, you know, knock us out. So we've got flat physical damage of plus 10. Magic resist of 6.2 and armor of 4.7. So if we come across another Gerund or other champions like that, we might do okay. We could do a tank build. We could do a tank build. That way we really wouldn't have to worry about. Go with 12 magic resist. Yeah, that would really Malafite with that sort of resistance. Oh dear lord. I'll go with 11 armor. I mean, you can build this around, but again, we're going with Garen, so. And we could go with utility, cooldown reduction, movement speed. Of course, Garen does need a little bit of movement, but he's got that spin to win, so we're not going to worry about that. So we'll just go physical and go again lethality if we really want to, which we don't, because lethality goes off crits. So let's go. Ooh, that's critical chance. So we're just going to go flat out physical damage. Bam. Okay, we're going to hit save. Now let's go to item sets. Let's click a new item set. We're going to change the name of this to Toot Gear. We're going to add a champion. Okay, maps and champions. Allow to be used with a specific champion. Fighter Garen. There we go. So now that we know that it's solely for Garen. There we go. So we know it's solely just for Garen. So if you play Garen, that's going to be in your list. Okay. So I'm going to look at items. And then first things first, what you could do is pull up, say, a website. Garen, and then it will give you, you know, simple look at the thumbs up to thumbs down ratios sort of thing. Let's take a look at this top one, shall we? Yes, I got it. The site uses cookies. Yes, I get it. The site uses cookies. Holy cow. Wow. Alright, so it looks like LOL Kings is having issues. So let's go to Moba Fire. Because Moba Fire is pretty good when it comes to that. Select champion. Garen. Apply. There we go. Garen can carry. It's a new guide, so let's take a look at it. Okay, so then it gives you ideas of what you need to use. Quintessences and whatnot, and then what you can do is here you just type in the item. So type in main star. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the video here, and you're going to come back and you're going to see the stuff that's been added. All right, we're back, guys, and as you can see, we've gone ahead and added everything that's needed, and we're just going to hit save. So there we go. There is the Garen tutorial build. We've got our runes. Now, of course, the guide says a mark of attack damage, which is what we have. Glyphs of scaling magic resist. Unfortunately, we don't have that. I just went with ability power, so we're going to take those out. And we're going to throw in... So it needs magic resist, is what they're saying. Defense. There you go. Magic resist is there. A seal of armor on here. I went with health regen, so we're going to go with seal of armor because that's what it wants. Boop, 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 boop. Go seal of armor. Done. Quint of attack damage and quint of movement speed. So quint of attack damage, and then quint of movement speed. There we go. So, yeah, great. We don't have all nine of each, but it's, you know, it's something. It's better than nothing. So and I just did it on the wrong one, didn't I? Yep, I just did it to my twisted fate. God dang it. Okay, movement speed, attack damage, seal of armor, resist. Okay, so yeah. Done. So, I'm gonna hit here. AI, summoner's wrist, beginner. Now again, I suggest you do beginner or intermediate. Once you're above level 10, stop doing beginner and start doing intermediate. And of course, the guy didn't fucking click ready, so. Thanks, Mazda. I hate that. Oh yeah, I'm gonna join a queue but not fight. I hate that crap.
My heart and sword always for Demacia.
And of course he wants us to use Ignite and Flash. So there we go. Let's take a look at Garen's skins. Ooh, I do like the soldier one. Very space marine. That's very space marine-y. So I'm locked in now, so we're waiting on the rest. And I've told them I'm going bottom, which is bot. We've got one guy who thinks he is the bee's knees, who wants to go top by himself. That's fine. Breaker of Cuffs wants to go mid, and I believe that's Katrina, yeah. So Just is playing Raven, Syngrid likes it, is pretty cool. Everyone lately is going with Teleport and Flash. And so let's give this build a try. It's asking me to get Decisive Strike as my first skill. And then of course Judgment, and then Courage, and then Judgment again for the first four levels, and that's fine. So let's give that a build. We'll give it a try. The guide is saying that Mundo, Flora, and Narcissus are your easiest to kill champions, with Pantheon, Olaf, Darius, Kyle, and Gnar being the hardest to kill. So we'll see, guys. We'll see. Who have we got? Okay, we've got Rekkon, which according to this build is a meh build. Warwick, which according to this build is actually not even listed. Wow. Annie, again, not even listed. Ash, again, not listed. So basically, and Turek, again, not listed. So the only one I've got to worry about is Rekkon here, pretty much, is what they're saying. They're saying in this build, the only champion I've got to worry about is Rekkon right here. So yay, let's give that a try then, shall we, guys? Now, of course, for Demacia! Now, I do have Flash, Ignite, sorry, which is pretty cool. What that does is does direct damage equal to my champion's level. Grievous Wounds reduces healing effects by 40%. His vision does not reveal stealthed enemies. So, again, and our main sword will do. His next basic attack within 4.5 seconds deals 30 plus 107 physical damage and silences the target for 1.4 seconds. Oof. That is nice. We're going to throw a ward right there. Uh-oh. Oh, here comes the dance, baby. Hell yeah. I just do this for last while I'm waiting.
The glory of Demacia will never fade.
Minions have spawned.
I've got a lot of weight on my shoulders.
Yes, you do, my friend. Okay. So again, because my champion's very transparent like that, it means I'm in stealth. And my passive is Perseverance. If Garen has not been struck by damage or enemy abilities for 9 seconds, he regenerates 12 health every 5 seconds, 2% of maximum health. Minion damage does not stop Perseverance. So minions... Of course you want to work on... Gotta work on my last hits. I don't care about... Again, I'm just lane farming right now. Our current must never win. Oh, got hit with a slow there. Looks like we just lost a ally to a tower. Okay, so judgment. Again, I got long lane sustain, again because of Garen's abilities, plus those runes that we chose. As they say, Garen spin to win. Now I could pop a heal pot here, in fact I will. And of course the build does say to get the shield at rank 4.
We fight for those who count.
Hitting with the ignite. Ah! Ash got me. Good kill. Okay, so I'm going to return now and start working on getting our other gear. Get some health pots too for the lane sustain. Again, guys, like I said, I usually don't play melee characters. I usually play ranged characters. So, Twisted Fate, Misfortune, Caitlyn, champions like that. So, we've all got our own learning curves, and like I said, you know, yes, this is a bot game, and yes, I did lose to a bot. Wow, who the hell cares? So, again, let's move on. Fear is the first of many things. Looks like they're going to do a push up top, but then again, she did say that she wanted top solo by herself, so that's why I'm not here. As long as I can. An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain. So that attack pushed. Ouch. I'm gonna heal up real quick. He's silenced. There we go. Nice, nice assist there. Again, this is how you're gonna learn, guys. Don't immediately go balls deep into straight PvP matches, because you're just going to get destroyed by players who already know what they're doing, you know, and various other things. So I'm just waiting for my ability to kick in. My there it goes. Perseverance is kicking in now, as you can see. I'm passively healing. I'm going to spin the wind. Bam. Of course, now we're going to go back to another Perseverance here. I'm going to hit my shield. Again, that way my Perseverance can heal right back up. As you can see, guys, I'm starting to heal up again, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. Okay, so we could return here soon. And at 700, that's what I'm going to do to get my Warden's Mail. I've got to work on my last hits with melee characters. We're gonna... And of course, now we're gonna get our ulti. Nice, there we go, first kill. There we go, there's our double kill. Used our ulti to finish him off. So we're gonna start working on this tower now. Get out of there, bro. So we're actually floating quite a lot of gold here now. So we're going to return back, let this guy do some lane push. So as we're recalling, he tapped P on your keyboard and it brings up your store. Now, I could actually get, you know, mid-game items now. I could get Warden's Mail. We could even get the Ninja Tabby. You know, we could look at getting some later on stuff, you know, mercenary treads. Stuns and slows won't hurt me so much. That actually, you know what? I'm actually thinking about getting the mercenary treads because that will severely hurt Ash from hurting us. So you know what? Actually, let's look at still sticking with the current build to keep in time. So there we go. Again, next recall is we're probably going to get the mercenary treads. Because we're going to need some run speed here soon. But like I said, guys, we could start working on working out on the Bruiser build. But for now, we're just going to go with the standard build, which was in the list. Again, I will post links to the build guide build in the video description down below. Along with...
An enemy has been slain.
Nice. So it looks like there's Ash is pushing back our Aatrox. Yeah, our Aatrox needs a little bit of love here. Needs some help. Okay, so we're going to pop our shield. We're going to spin the win. And... oh, there's the ulti. Right there. And we're going to silence him. Nice, nice, nice. And is that going to be... Is that? Okay, so we're going to get our spin to win up again. And check it out, we're actually even starting to heal now after killing that champion. Again, we are now floating 600 gold. Tap P again, always want to check. So at 1100, we're going to get our mercenary treads, guys. Which we should get from destroying this tower. Again, we're going to spin the wind just because we can. Yeah, we are now level 7. Here comes Rekkon, who is by the tower. So we've got to be careful because he might try and pull us in. There you go. Turret is down. There's our pop. There's our spin to win. Now, bear in mind, we don't have Ignite. Our Ignite is still down for another 20 seconds. Okay, we got our spin to win back up. There's still two on this lane. We're now floating the 1100 gold that's needed, so we're going to head back to here, to little bushes, and we're going to teleport back. Tap that, Pete, and remember, we want to get the mercenary treads, okay? So I'm going to pop and buy that outright. There's our mercenary treads, which is the end game items that we need. So we've already got our end game boots, which is a good thing. And so the next item we're going to solely working on is probably Dead Man's Plate, which is going to be 1900 gold with this current build. And then from there, we can work on probably getting, say, the Black Cleaver, because that will stack with our Judgment, I believe. And if it does stack with Judgment, that'd be great. Courage, of course. Passive killing units permanently grants armor. Yep. Active defensive shield. So, yeah, we don't even have to hit the W key. We can just passive just to keep toggling it now. Next two levels is we're going to be popping up our Decisive Strike. Again, there's the spin to win. There's the spin to win. And there's the silence. Of course, our ulti is up, which we're not going to pop yet, because we've also got our ignite as well. Okay. Oh. Yep. Coming in. Come on then. Like I said, Ashe's slows aren't really doing much anymore. We're gonna spin the win. Bam. There we go. Do some nice farming damage here. Get some farm minion going. Like so. Now. More spin to win. There's a big old hit right there with our ulti. Now we could get some cooldown reduction to lower. All right. Now again, I'm not going to pop my shield yet, because again, shield's something you want to pop. There we go, there she goes. Nice assist there. So 4 kills, 1 death, 3 assists so far. And we are level 9. Now so we're going to put another point in our beautiful decisive strike. That's now going to do over 250 damage. Ooh, and silence a target. We're going to do some more spin to win. Alright. Okay, so here comes Derek again. We march as one. We're floating 1200 gold now. Oh. Ooh. No, he shot me down. Oh well. Did what I could. Alright, so let's look at getting some more end gear. We're off floating 1300 gold. Now we could get the chain vest, which will lower the overall cost down to 1100, and we are floating another 500 and change. So what we could do is we could get the elixir of iron. No, we won't get that for now. That'll be a potential we'll get later on down the line. I really would like to get the Dead Man's Plate first, so that will pop in at 1100 gold. Legendary. Nice one. Check that out, guys. Okay, we are now rank 9. So at rank 10, we get another point in our spin to win in Judgment. And then after that, we put another point in Demacian Justice. Okay, there's Annie. Let's see what we can do. Oh! Annie just got shut the hell down. Let's knock out this. Again. Okay. Oh, that's right, in the rework, you spin the wind doesn't do anything to turrets anymore. Oh, okay. Okay, so level 10, we're gonna pop that. Oh, couldn't get the ignite off. Okay, so I'm going to recall now, because I do have the gold for the dead man's plate, and that's what we're going to get, because it is part of our damage build. Bam, there's the dead man's plate, and now we're going to start working on probably knocking out the Syrix gauge. Nice, another turret destroyed. Looks like we are pushing in, and it might even be over. Let's see, our end farming is 42 minions compared to, jeez louise, Papa Cheese. Dude, look at that, 141 minion farm. Looks like someone knows what they're doing. Of course, we now have our dead man's plate buff. Right there, momentum. Check that out, guys, check that out. She's aced it. Nice, nice, nice. We didn't get dragon, nor did we go for baron, but we could have done that. Okay, so we're going to hold right here, wait for the minion wave to come along to distract the turret while we get in there, like so. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Let's get some damage done on this turret. A quadra kill. Oh, can I get it? Oh, and the ignite goes off. Nice. Okay, we are popped at rank at level 11. So we're going to get another point in our ulti. That'll get the cooldown. We're going to do some spin to win here. Like so. Do some damage to this turret. Look at those assists. Nice. 6 assists, 5 kills, 2 deaths. We're doing it here. We're going to knock out this inhibitor. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, hit the stun there. Hit the spin to win. Oh, another assist. Oh, Ash hit us with the slow. Doesn't really do anything because of our boots. There goes an inhibitor. We are going to hit that recall. Just so I can look at getting my Joram's Fist. And we did just hit rank 12. Ah, guess what? Bam, Damascene Sword. We are going to go pop, pop. So it's going to be 1150. 1115, and anyway, like I say, guys, we're working on our last build, but most of you want to focus on economy. Don't go bother going like this Katrina and going off on kills, 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 because believe it or not, eventually you're just not going to get the gold. You're only ever going to get maybe 50 gold to 150 gold per kill when you're better off farming.
Double kill.
Okay, we're gonna get a spin the wind going in here. Like so, work on this inhibitor. We do have our super units getting ready to move in.
Double kill.
All right, remember 1150, guys, 1150. Look at that, 621 damage in that spin to win. That is awesome sauce. Gonna knock that out. Get another spin to win going. So we're on their dungeon heart now, and I know it's not called the dungeon heart, but I'm an old school GG. And well, guys, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a comment down below if you have any questions. Again, I will post links to the build and everything else that you saw down there. Let's take a look at the graphs real quick. Damage dealt to champions. Yeah, I only did maybe 11k. And of course, our freaking breaker of cuffs just went ham again. Again, you're new to the game. You're not going to be doing what that other champion did. You're not going to be doing what this champion did. All you're going to be doing is roughly about what you're doing here. But you forget, like I said, you're still new to the game. You're still growing. You're still learning. If you did like the video, please give the video a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. And it helps the channel grow. Hit the subscribe button if you want more League of Legends content, as well as other games such as Heroes and Generals, War Thunder, and World of Tanks and World of Warships and various other games like that. I am, of course, Danny Deceptive Cobras on one hand, and I will see you guys in the next video, my friends. So take care.